All right, welcome back, everybody. Bob Stauffer with the Oilers Radio Network at the NHL Scouting Combine for Oilers TV, and we're joined by Fort Saskatchewan product Kirby Dach. And Kirby, what's this week overall been like for you?
Yeah, it's been a lot of fun. I mean, you don't get to experience this too often in your life, so I've kind of come here and taken advantage of every aspect of it and met new people and made some friendships that'll last a lifetime. So, I mean, I've had a lot of fun, and I'm happy the fitness testing's over and that part's done with, but it's been a lot of fun.
How many different, you're a consensus top six or seven overall pick. How many different NHL teams ended up speaking to you this weekend?
I think I had 11 meetings this week, so I mean, it was good to kind of meet teams and see what they had to say and about me and what I can improve on and that stuff. And there's things for me to take back and kind of work on in my game.
You had an interesting season, took off obviously in the playoffs and tremendous against Prince Albert, including scoring a big goal there that got a lot of attention. Just a thought maybe on elevating your play at a critical juncture against a really good team.
Yeah, I mean, I kind of, before playoffs, looked at myself in the mirror and said I want to try and find a new gear every night to kind of help push my team through each round. So I think I was able to kind of do that against Moose Jaw, and then coming up against Prince Albert, I knew I'd have to find an extra gear, because I mean, they're a big, strong team, and they went to the Memorial Cup for a reason. I mean, their decor this year was fantastic. They had five 19-year-old D-men that were able to shut everybody down at the right times and right moments, and then they had those forwards that were smart and skilled, and it would make you pay for if you made a mistake in the D zone. So it was a good series to be in and taught me a lot about myself.
What did it mean for your team, your organization? You know, for years they missed the playoffs, and then for you guys to take that step forward this season.
Yeah, it was huge. I mean, the buzz around the city was a little bit different in past years. When I was 16, you kind of go places and people wouldn't really know who you are. It's a little bit bigger of a community, but being in playoffs and being how good we were this year, you're starting to get a little bit more recognition from the fan base in Saskatoon, and so it was a lot of fun. The rink was starting to fill up, and it's been a while since anybody's seen that rink like that.
Joffrey Lupul, Mike Commodore, Ray Whitney. There's a bit of a lineage there, Fort Saskatchewan guys that have gone on and played in the NHL.
Yeah, it's pretty neat. I mean, you kind of go to the rink and you see all those guys' pictures hanging up along the walls and stuff like that, and to think that maybe my name could be up there one day would be pretty cool.
Favorite player growing up as a kid?
I watched a lot of Jonathan Toews, but kind of growing up as a kid in Edmonton, I watched a lot of Alex Hemsky in that kind of his era, and that was good. But my favorite player growing up was probably Toews.
Are you a guy, you played a little on the wing, getting back to like a Gretzky last year, but primarily a center. What do you think is the biggest area of improvement that you need to work on your game to get to the next level?
Yeah, I think so. I think I kind of see myself as a centerman more than a winger, and just one thing that kind of work on is that consistency, and I know how good I can be every night, and it's whether or not I can bring that consistent level of play. And I think towards the end of the year I was kind of able to figure that out and bring it.
Your dad was a college player in Edmonton. Just a thought on the assistance. Your brother's drafted by Saskatoon as well. The sort of the connectivity with the family there helping you get to this level.
Yeah, it's been pretty good. I mean, my dad kind of helped to groom the game for me and my brother, and he taught us and he got into it. I got us into it. So I mean, we kind of took it and ran with it, and he's given us every tool that we needed to succeed in life, and without my parents I wouldn't be here today.
That's Fort Saskatchewan's Kirby Dach.